to think if they win this one and control it, the D-man at the checkered line, that they at least get him off now. Do you think?
Still there, Doc.
Okay. Back in deep it comes. They battle for it there, and it's rifled on around further by Chernak. And then walked on, a crossover, and a shot blocked down. Rebound scramble for it. Oh, it wouldn't go there. Well, it's a good thing they kept it in, isn't it? So now it is lobbed on out again by Bogosian, and back down and stopped there. With 2:25 to go and the power play over, and that one directed up high and out of play.
Well, Blake, you know, just a natural scrum, but if you go intentionally rip off a guy's helmet, and there's a rule list, let's just put it
on. Carried back along now by Haskin. Haskin and fired it back around.
Get off the helmet there in Montreal.
Hello guys, what is up? Bringing you a new video. Today I will be watching the final minutes here of Game 6 of the Stanley Cup Final live. And then I will be giving my thoughts, should the Lightning win, on what that means for them. So let's get it on. 54 seconds here. Stars have an empty net. Stars are really pressing. They're passing the puck around. Klingberg's got it at the point. Passes down the right wing to Ben. Ben tries to get it on net, blocked by the Lightning defender. 40 seconds left. Ben gets it back, shoots, and out of play. A faceoff is in Tampa's zone here. If Dallas is going to have any hope at winning this game, they're going to have to score like immediately here. Tampa Bay just got it out of the zone. Nope, he got back in. Stars are racing in here. Just missed the net with a big shot there. So Klingberg passed it to the other wing, shoots, rebound, and no shot. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, pressuring, puts out of the zone. Lightning, are you 2020?
And trying to get there, and to get a trigger pull, but shot that went wide that time.
Are you 2020? Stanley Cup champions!
Lightning have won.
Andrei Vasilevskiy took off his mask, kissed his helmet. Like it. Man, that's huge for the Lightning here. I'm intrigued to see who gets the cup first. I'd like to see if Stammer actually comes on the ice. And if he does, he gets the first handoff for sure. I feel like there's a chance of Victor Hedman. I'm just trying to think of like veterans on this team that have won a cup, like maybe Patty DeRue.
Concluding
yeah, Stammer's out there.
Period.
He's gonna get the
of tremendous competition.
But man, this is a tough series, but I feel like almost every game starts to simply outplay.
Both
like,
on and
five,
away from the bubble rinks.
There's no question in my mind. I thought
game
the Lightning should have won that game.
Day 59.
The Lightning played better, and the Stars just ended up being great.
One team will get
but
their names
finally,
on the trophy.
Like, I thought this year, if the Lightning didn't win,
the other disappointed.
Start to roll, they might have to start shaking up the
roster. But deep in the heart of Texas,
because for 5 years
what
since 2015,
a gallant performance
when they lost
the team
in the
green.
In Chicago, that was all right. They
and John
really
Cooper has now won
at
every level
team,
that he has coached.
But Chicago was a really tough team that it obviously won it two times before. So I think Chicago was mostly favored. And then after that, it was like almost every year after that.
After they congratulate
the
each other.
Because it made sense. They had the core.
And get over
the
glorious
and they had
shock
that iconic playoff
of having won.
Think
they
back.
Realized
before
that
the
there is another noble
their,
tradition
won
of all of this.
Their first cup, for example, they famously lost to the Islanders.
And that is the handshake.
You know,
patiently waiting at the other
history
end for that.
And just so the Lightning now had that loss. So everyone thought like.
And you saw Steven Stamkos.
I think the Ducks were actually
who only got to
like
play a little bit in
other
one
than that,
game, the captain of the team.
Been favorites almost every other year.
But said after that game,
and
I have a great
just,
feeling
like,
about
Phil,
all of
you know,
this. And now the line forms.
Lost once last year, obviously.
For this
great
noble tradition.
Points record. And also missed the playoffs 1 year because of like all their injuries. Stammer was out for all but 20 games. Kucherov was just leading them. and Hedman started breaking his own that year. But
Doc,
like,
a lot of people said that, you know, the National Hockey League wouldn't be able to pull this off.
The handshake now.
And they did in a big way.
Just kind of shaking everyone's hand. With I kind of feel bad for
from a lot of people.
And Perry, too. But
these
more
teams, these coaches, these players, these trainers,
this is probably his last real shot at it. I think, like, now that they've lost
incredible
this,
theater.
He's not going to get another
an incredible
shot
entertainment.
This good, I don't believe. So like
the understanding of what's going on in the real world.
Last year, that iconic loss to the Blue Jackets.
A valiant effort by the Dallas Stars.
And then also
the Tampa Bay Lightning
twice.
Were on a mission, Doc.
And so,
no doubt about it.
That leads up to this year. And I just, like, the team really came together. They were well rested. Braden Point and Victor Hedman in particular.
Many of us remember.
On fire. Like, Victor Hedman, what, third all time?
When Team USA defeated
in one playoff
Team
year,
Russia at
insane.
The Olympics.
Braden Point just
well,
leading
after
that team. Like, just
Russia won the world
points.
Championships, and there are two of the goalies
insane.
From that team.
From both players. I'll just check the
they both wound up getting
exact
cards.
Stats quickly here.
From leader of the
So let's talk
Russian Federation
Conn Smythe Trophy winners now that I've discussed.
This will be a different kind of reward for Vasilevsky this time.
I think
and
it's going to be Braden Point.
By Rick Bonus, who was an assistant
here.
Coach
just to, like,
in Tampa Bay
when
Vasilevsky
sure
first
that,
came
like,
in.
He got the
game
winning goal tonight in 2015. He actually got, yeah.
So
he got
he
first
knows
goal
so
tonight,
many of these players from his 5 years.
The Lightning won 2-0.
As an associate and an assistant
coach. I'm trying to
find,
but you can't seem to... It doesn't look like you can actually search up players anymore. It's just kind of stupid. I'm not going to say. Okay. So I'm going to go to NHL.com then.
He has been a coach
still doing handshake,
for 5 decades, Rick Bonus.
But, you know, I'm...
And there just aren't very
really
many
wanna,
that
like,
don't like this guy. And I think you can see it
show
displayed
you guys,
on
and
his
I'm
face.
Trying to bring it up, but I can't find it anywhere. So... Give me a sec while I try to find this. So, 32 points in 22 games, but this hasn't been updated
and there
yet.
Are the
so,
congratulations
23
at the two
games
victorious,
and
the victorious
unless,
coach and
yeah,
the one
33 points.
Who was not.
So, just absolutely, like, insane by him.
Following a great tournament
without
in 2 months.
They wouldn't be here. So, points, probably my favorite. Hedman is obviously up there as well. And then Andre Palat got 11 goals this year's playoffs. All clutch goals, too. Like, they were big goals that he had. So, I think he makes, like, a case. He's not going to win, but he has a case, for sure. But overall, I think it's going to go to Point. I really do. Just... I think he's just been too important to this roster, especially without Stammer, too. Just being there for that team and just making sure that they get there. And obviously, he's also been there for the other runs as well. Yeah, 18 points in 24 games, including 11 goals. So, yeah. And again, as I said, big goals. He came alive in that... Islanders series, or no, it was the Boston series, and obviously, like, taking 7th round, too, what a steal, and huge for that group, too. Nikita Kucherov even has a case. Let me just quickly bring up his stats now, which is a lot easier. 33 points in 24 games, that's a lot better stats than I thought. So, actually, like, Kucherov makes a big case there. If you're gonna give it to anyone on the Stars, I think Godobin or Heskinen, but I don't think they're gonna do that. I'm just looking at Vasilevsky's stats, and they are actually really good. 17-7, 1.97 goals against average, .925 save percentage. So, you know what? I think Vasilevsky has a small case as well. Then again, he's only had to make 718 saves, which, like, that's... That seems like a lot, and that is a lot of saves, but not compared to, like, as many, like, how much other goalies have had to face, like Markstrom in Vancouver, you know, like those guys. So I don't think he's going to win, because it's most valuable player in the Stanley Cup playoffs, And I'll quickly bring up Hedman's stats as well, because I want to kind of look at all the options quickly and see everyone's stats. Yeah, so 21 points, 24 games for Hedman, including 10 goals. Just insane for them. So I think Point, Palat, Kucherov, Hedman, and Vasilevskiy have all been those key focal points. They're just awarding it now. I predict it's going to go to Braden Point. Or Victor Hedman. It's going to be one of those two, but I'm going to see Braden Point right now and just see who gets it. Gary Bettman just announcing it now.
...is remarkable and frankly overwhelming. It's a testament to
his accomplishments are overwhelming.
Play, and it's a testament to a great
his return to play.
From the Tampa Bay Lightning.
It's a testament to a great Stanley Cup final from the Lightning and the Stars. Conn Smythe Trophy winner. Yeah, and most valuable player of the playoffs.
All of the players who participated should feel like MVPs. But there's one.
All players should feel like MVPs in the final. 10 goals, 11 assists, third all-time in defenseman. It's Victor Hedman. Okay, I thought that was going to be Braden Point, but Hedman. Okay. Hedman was definitely my second choice. He's definitely a deserving winner for me. So that ends with the Conn Smythe. He absolutely towers over Gary Bettman. He's like a foot taller at least. Just insane. So, man, I think he's definitely a deserving winner. He wasn't my absolute first choice. I would have gone with Braden Point, as I said before. But, you know what? Good for him. Gets a Conn Smythe trophy. I think he's due at Norris, for sure. Or another Norris. Sorry, he's 1-1. And so, I want to see who the first Stanley Cup... handoff is going to be, I feel like it's kind of obvious, like, it's going to be Stammer. They're going to give it to Stammer. Actually, no, wait, they're not, because Stammer, as the captain, is going to get, like, he's going to get the cup first. So we're going to see him raise that. And then, now a pass-off after that, I'm thinking he's going to do someone that's been with him all these years. So I think it's going to be a guy like Palat. I think Palat might get it. I'm just thinking, like, strategically.
Why does it have to be Tampa?
It's just, oh my goodness, that trophy. There's a reason they call it the hardest trophy in hockey to win. And this year especially, I feel like especially this year's winner is especially hard. Like, Lightning didn't, they had to be off a long layoff. They were missing Stammer, obviously. And then the whole Black Lives Matter movement, like, that interrupted a small part of the playoffs as well. They obviously didn't have to go through the play-in round, but, you know, they also conquered their demons as well this season. Like, Columbus, who absolutely manhandled them last in the first round, they easily, I wouldn't say easily, but, like, definitely beat in the five games, including the 5-0 winner, or thriller. Just give it a sec. So, Bettman is talking about the Stanley Cup now. So he's just like congratulating the staff. So Breezebaugh, the GM, and then Cooper, the coach, and those guys. I honestly did think that this year, if Cooper didn't lead the Lightning to at least the Cup final, I felt Cooper would be fired. Especially once they went up 3-1 on the Islanders. I thought if they lose to the Islanders, Cooper's fired. And one of those guys is traded. Probably not like Stammer or Point, not any of those guys, but maybe a guy like Killorn or Cirelli, one of those slightly lesser guys. So Stammer's gonna get the cup first. He's just bringing up the players for the presentation of the cup. But anyway, so then in the second round, they've had issues with the Bruins in the past, but they easily disposed of them this year. In five games. And then in the conference finals, they face a very resilient Islanders team, this year's equivalent of the Nuggets as well this year. And then, obviously, in the finale, they had to face a pretty tough Dallas team that had a hot goalie that they managed to break. Bettman's just talking about, like, how it's the hardest trophy in the world to win. But I feel like more than any other team, the Lightning, it was time for them to win. It's been time for them to win for a few years, as I said earlier. But, like, this is definitely going to go down in the record books, for sure. This year's Cup win, obviously with Poland as well, but just the story of the Lightning winning after years of disappointment, being probably the most pressured team in hockey to, to win. Like, they were the most pressured team, no doubt, this year to win it. And then, obviously, with, like, Stammer being out. And there's Stammer raising it. Kissing the trophy. I feel like Stammer really does deserve, the trophy. Even though he didn't play, so I don't think his name is going to be extra on the cup, because I don't think he actually meets the games played requirements. First pass off is... Who is it? Victor Hedman! Okay, so I was wrong again. Thought, I guess I overthought it. You know, give it to Hedman. Next guy is... He gave it to Braden Coburn. Yeah, he is a Lightning veteran. Someone I didn't think of, so that's... That choice is fine. Next guy, who did he give that to? Ryan McDonough. Okay. Obviously, like, he's never won a cup before, you know, played for the Rangers. Came close in 2014. Next guy was Alex Killorn. Now, I thought he might be the, no, that wasn't Alex Killorn, it was someone else, but I don't know who it was. Next was Luke Shen. He's doing, like, lesser names. I'm surprised Kucherov hasn't gotten a turn yet. Or Brayden Point, or one of those guys. Looks like Patty Maroon got the Nets handoff. No, it was Zach Bogosian. Sorry, it's hard to read from these guys' faces. Like, it really is. So, I'm really glad the Lightning won this year. Next to my favorite team, the Canucks. Yeah, Maroon just got it after Bogosian. The Lightning were probably second in my books to win the Cup. There you go. Kucherov's finally getting it after Maroon. So, and I always like to see. I keep like a personal checklist, if you will, in my mind about just which players have won the cup. Like players that one name might go in the Hall of Fame. There you go. Vasilevskiy's getting a turn. And I feel like more than any other team in the NHL right now, maybe the Leafs up there as well. They have like Hedman, Stammer, Kucherov, Point. And Vasilevskiy could all go down one day as Hall of Famers. Stammer, I think he has to get in. Because there are guys that haven't been as decorated as he is that have gotten in. Like, what is it, Kevin Lau? He's not as decorated as Stammer. No major awards. Like, obviously lots of Stanley Cups. But now Stammer has a cup too. So, there you go. Braden Point's finally getting in as well. So, I think Stammer has to get in. Kucherov has a scoring title, and he set the new points per game record for this millennial. Although, Draisaitl came within 0.1 of it this year and might have surpassed it if the season hadn't been shortened, but that doesn't matter. Hedman has a Norris Trophy. If he can continue to win more, I could easily see him in the Hall of Fame. And Point, that comes with a bit of projection. But I feel like if he keeps playing as well as he did this year in the playoffs... As I said before, I thought he was going to win the Conn Smythe. Even if he didn't, he was pretty close. He's proven he can come clutch. So, this is assuming he gets even better and he can start producing like that in the regular season. And then the last guy is Vasilevskiy, who, for the next decade, is, like, he's probably going to win, like, two or three Vezina trophies, which most goalies that do that usually get in the Hall of Fame. Bobrovsky is probably going to get in the Hall of Fame. He has multiple Vezina trophies. And usually stuff like multiple individual awards is usually enough to get you a... At least a consideration. So, I feel like... You know, I have like a personal checklist in my head. Like, okay, which Hockey Hall of Famers or like future Hockey Hall of Famers have a cup? And, you know, probably number one on that list of guys that didn't before today was Stammer. Because you have Crosby, he has a cup. Ovi, he has a cup. Kane, he has a cup. Erik Karlsson doesn't have a cup. It's debatable whether you have him over Stammer. You might not. I feel like Karlsson had a slightly higher, like, peak. Because, like, points per game for a defenseman is absolute insanity. Stammer's been better for longer. So it depends on how you look at it, for sure. He doesn't have a cup. He's the other guy up there, but Carlson isn't elite anymore. And we know Stammer, when he does play, still can be. And, like, there's a long list of players that almost all have cups. Like, the other elite player that, like, he's not elite anymore, but he doesn't have a cup, and he has been elite in the past, like, couple decades, is Joe Thornton. He doesn't have a cup either, and, you know, obviously he won an Art Ross Trophy, 125 points, I think it was that year. Only one to win, you know, Art Ross while being traded mid-season, which made sense because, you know, no team but the Bruins would trade a future Art Ross Trophy winner. And not even that future, that same season. Stammer's definitely on top of that list for me. And then all the other guys I listed, now they have cups too. And I like to see variety, which I feel like the NHL, more than any other league in the world, provides, or sports league in particular. So, the Leafs might be able to match up. They have, like, Matthews, they have Tavares, who Tavares is going to be at least considered. He's like he's like an older version of Braden Point. Not in the style, but, like, in the how likely they will be to get a cup one day, you know? Or to get in the Hall of Fame, sorry. So they have Matthews, Tavares. Marner has a shot one day. He has to play better than he does. Nylander's a first-liner, but he's probably like a Patrick Elias situation, so most likely not getting in. And then Morgan Rielly, too. But I feel like their cast isn't as good. The only one of those guys that I actually truly see getting in the Hall of Fame one day is Matthews, because I feel like he's going to win a couple Rocket Richards. And I feel like he's going to get, like, top 30 in all-time goals list. So for those reasons alone, I feel like, combine that with, like, a couple cups, because the Leafs eventually are going to do it. It might not be for a couple years, but they will do it eventually. Like, he will win a cup, and he's pretty high on my list, too, of guys that haven't won a cup, but it's part of it is, like, how old they are, and Stammer's obviously quite a few years older than Matthews. But anyway, guys, they are just doing the team photo now. I just wanted to kind of get into the live last minute and then talk about them winning the cup. That would have been pretty interesting if Dallas had managed to come back. That would have been a really good live thing. But anyway, guys, that is going to do it for this video. I appreciate you guys listening and watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.